Does Netflix have a brand new franchise on their hands here? Let's find out. Okay, Enola Holmes. Now, Enola Holmes follows the story of the titular character, who's played here by Millie Bobby Brown from Stranger Things. And in this movie, her mother, who's played by Helena Bonham Carter, goes missing, and she is put in the care of her two brothers, Sherlock and Mycroft, the former of which is a master detective that is world-renowned and is played by Henry Cavill. Mycroft is played by Sam Claflin. And she decides, since they really have no desire to try to find their mother, she decides to go out on her own, be a detective in her own right, and find her mother while unraveling a political conspiracy in the process. Now, I was actually looking forward to this movie because the trailer was pretty damn charming. I really like the concept of a, you know, Enola Holmes movie, not a Sherlock Holmes movie, where it was nice to see that, like, Sherlock and Mycroft are going to be more supporting characters than anything else, and that this was going to be Millie Bobby Brown's show. At least that was my hope going into the movie, and I just wanted to have a good time, and it looked like it was breaking the fourth wall and all that, and I was like, alright, let's see if this gamble pays off. And honestly, it really does. This is one of the most charming movies of 2020. This is way better than it has any right to be, and I think this is a really fun adventure movie and a nice little twist on, like, the Holmes family, and I really think that this could be a potentially great franchise for Netflix if this movie does well on the streaming service. Now, as I mentioned in the plot description of this movie's got a great cast. I mean, like I said, we've got Millie Bobby Brown, we've got Henry Cavill, we've got Sam Claflin, we've got a bunch of familiar faces popping up, Helena Bonham Carter, and everyone here is terrific. Millie Bobby Brown in particular is fantastic as Enola. She's charming, she's charismatic, she's got chemistry with virtually everybody, she's clearly having a blast breaking the fourth wall and just being this character, and she carries this movie effortlessly. I mean, this is her movie. I mean, I'm really glad that they really shine the spotlight on this character. They don't have her relying on Sherlock or Mycroft or anyone else to kind of bail her out of situations. She has to stumble before she can really walk and run, and it's a learning process for her. This movie is basically her kind of, you know, becoming the person that she was meant to be and kind of embracing who she is at her very core. So kind of seeing her go on that journey and have this movie actually focus on that journey was really nice. And she just nails every bit of this movie, though. You know, the stunts that she does, the humor, the heart, it's all there. And Millie Bobby Brown proves that she's a star, and she's not just 11 from Stranger Things. She has a lot more potential here, and I think that she's showing a lot more versatility in this movie, and I think it's going to be great seeing her in more things like this. And Henry Cavill is great as Sherlock Holmes. I really like that he kind of made this character his own. I mean, this is a character we've seen done to death. We've seen so many adaptations of this character, but seeing him kind of have a warmer kind of Sherlock, a Sherlock that definitely has more humanity than maybe past versions that we've seen of the character, was great. And, you know, seeing the detective skills at play, the way they, like, visually, you know, show his skills, very similar to previous adaptations, but Cavill definitely adds his own charm and his own charisma to the character, and I really like the way he slowly kind of, you know, reveals his heart as the movie goes on, especially when it comes to Enola, who he definitely cares for, but kind of has a wall up because he doesn't want it to interfere with his work, and he doesn't want to, like, let her down again since he kind of left her, you know, when she was just a little girl. And Sam Claflin just loves playing assholes, and, and he's really damn good at it. And he's great as Mycroft, though, because the whole Mycroft-Sherlock dynamic, it's always one of my favorite dynamics, you know, in the stories and the adaptations. I really do think that they kind of nailed that here, and Claflin and Cavill have great chemistry with one another. Yes, they're vastly different people, but, you know, at the end of the day, they're brothers, they want to grab a drink, they want to catch up, they want to support one another, and it's kind of great, and I love seeing those two interact. They're fantastic, but man, sometimes I forget Sam Claflin can actually be like a warm, good-hearted dude when I see him in roles like this, or his, you know, little stint in Peaky Blinders. I mean, the guy plays a magnificent douche. And the rest of the cast is great, and what I really loved about this movie is that it's super well-edited, it's slick, it's really well-crafted, it's directed by Harry Bradbeer, who, if you don't know that name, he directed multiple episodes of Amazon's hit series Fleabag, which is phenomenal if you have not seen that. So he's definitely no stranger to tackling material where the main character breaks the fourth wall. So he was definitely ideally suited for this material, and he does a great job. I think visually the action sequences are really fun and dynamic. It's great seeing how Enola kind of breaks the fourth wall. It's not overdone. It's not, you know, overutilized. I think there's some really great moments where it's just like a facial expression, just kind of like a wink to the audience. And sometimes getting the audience involved in a sequence where maybe Enola's stuck and is like, you know, there's even a point where she even says, "Do you have any ideas?" It just, like, little things like that make it a really fun, involving experience. And this movie's never boring. It kind of flies by. I mean, it's a smidge, I would say, too long. Like, the ending feels like it goes on, like, 10 minutes too much. But other than that, this is a movie that really flies by. It's fun. It's entertaining. It's heartfelt. It leaves plenty of room for potential sequels if this movie does well, like I said before, which I would be absolutely open to. I think Netflix definitely has a potentially great franchise on their hands here. And I think if this cast returns and we get some new additions and we get some more fun stories, I think this could be a really, really fun franchise that Netflix can kind of keep revisiting. Really, the only problem I have with this movie is that the whole political conspiracy that comes into play toward the end of the movie is very predictable. I mean, the reveal is not really much, you know, in terms of shock value. I mean, it's just kind of like, oh, yeah. Okay, I've seen this done a million times before, I kind of saw this coming. Nothing groundbreaking, but this movie really is more about the journey of Enola Holmes to becoming kind of the young detective and, you know, brave young woman that she was always meant to be. And I think when the movie focuses on that, it really shines. And when it focuses on, like, the central mystery, it kind of falls short because it's really not all that captivating or engaging. But in the end, though, if you're looking for just a really fun, entertaining watch, especially in times like these, definitely put on Enola Holmes on Netflix. I think it's a super fun time. I think if you're just a fan of, you know, adventure films or like Sherlock Holmes movies or, you know, stories, you know, that are akin to that, I think you'll really enjoy this one and definitely want a sequel. And in the end, I'm going to give Enola Holmes, I'm going to give this movie a B+. Just a really fun movie from start to finish, further showcasing Millie Bobby Brown's talents in front of the camera. And she's anchored by, you know, a really great supporting cast, where Henry Cavill just continues to show how damn charismatic he is, which is just ridiculous. He's been given way too many gifts from God. It's not fair, but I'll get over that later. And we've got a wonderful cast and a wonderful director at the helm here, and I just think overall this is just a very satisfying family adventure film. So that is my review of Enola Holmes. Really hope you enjoyed it. Really hope you take it into consideration. If you consider seeing this film or not, make sure to subscribe to my channel for more movie reviews and TV reviews. Plenty of those coming your way. Have you seen Enola Holmes? You know, what did you think of it? You know, let me know in the comment box below. Or if you haven't seen it, are you gonna watch it? Let me know. Equally interested. And until next time, everybody, I'm Tom Chattelbash, YouTube's most reliable movie critic.